afternoon. Our next guests are going to be talking about biotechnology. John Melo has 30 years of combined experience as an entrepreneur and thought leader in developing and growing technology companies and as a senior executive in the oil and gas industry. As president and chief executive officer, Mr. Melo had led Amyris, the company we are going to be talking about today, through successful technology development, industrial startup, product development, and commercialization, and a series of funding rounds, including the initial public offering. Dr. Manuela Pintado is associate professor at the School of Biotechnology at Universidade Católica Portuguesa and the scientific coordinator of the Alchemy Project, which is a center of excellence at the university focused on the areas of biotechnology and circular economy, bringing together bioengineering, microbiology, and bioanalytical skills to develop new molecules of commercial interest, in particular for the pharmaceutical, cosmetic, and food industries. So they are here to tell us how and why the Alchemy Project came to be, as well as their present and future expectations for it. Thank Welcome.
You. Thank you so much. I think John starts, no? Can you? Okay, I can start.
Yes.
Okay, so thank you so much. It's a great pleasure to be here today. I'll start talking about Alchemy Projects and how we start this collaboration with Amyris. So, in fact, we have for the future, it expected in 2050, to the need to more 70% of materials in the world than in 2005. And in fact, this is a problem because we need to create new materials from new sources, because using non-sustainable sources leads to the land, plants, and animal endangerment. And besides that, several of our resources are ending, so we need to find new sources for them. Amyris is creating new molecules based in synthetic biology, as John will explain soon. But at that moment, Amyris went to be disrupted behind this synthetic biology, especially trying to approach to the circular economy. And at that moment, the need and the challenge was to waste stream valorization and to create valuable co-products from there. So, in fact, when you do the fermentation, in the value chain of this fermentation, we generate a lot of wastes from the sugar cane that we need to take the sugar. Also, during the fermentation, we generate a lot of spent yeast, but also different liquid phases, separations that need to be valorized, as well as evaporation residues. And from these wastes, we can take different molecules that Amyris at that moment would like to apply in their own business, namely cosmetics, but also to establish symbiotic applications with other industries in the field of animal feeding, food, or materials. So why did we start this collaboration? In fact, Amyris had at that moment these challenges, and us in Portugal, Catholic University, in the Center of Biotechnology and Fine Chemistry, we start working with waste valorization mainly from agro-food since 1993. And when circular economy started, we have been collaborating with different companies where we could have some different case studies and sharing with John Melo at that moment, we demonstrated to have a great track record in this waste valorization, and also we had different experience valorizing molecules, creating new opportunities, because each molecule can itself have different properties that you can use to apply in different fields. And finally, Catholic University has a strong collaboration with other European centers and also getting funding from European Commission and could be a good partner to support this collaboration in Portugal. So based on that, we started the collaboration in 2016, and this collaboration started looking for all their residues, waste streams, and byproducts. And then we create a project that is at the moment installed in our building in Porto, where we have the Alchemy Research Center integrated in CBKF, our Center of Biotechnology and Fine Chemistry. So every day, we have 70 researchers from UC Catholic University and also from Amyris that work, collaborate daily to transform the sciences and the science and the creativity and the innovation that you find every day in our labs. Directly with Amyris, we try to create a leading culture for a world-class business-driven innovation. And this is really important because we generate the knowledge and immediately we are starting implementing and creating value from there through Amyris. So this Alchemy project is a 42 million project and we integrate 70 researchers. So it's also very important because we could integrate 70 researchers that every day create things for circular economy based on waste streams. And also it's not only the only objective of the project is on not only waste stream valorization, but we also have the capacity using our labs to promote and to make the fermentation more sustainable with more productivity. And also we are trying to create more advanced softwares in order to have a better platform for synthetic biology in order to create more sustainable molecules together with Amyris. So in this case, this project is generating science, but at the same time, the science that will be disseminated throughout the world will be transformed every day in sales because Amyris is there to transform it immediately with different partners in value. Also, it's really important to team. When you have these projects, and especially circular economy, it's not easy just to work with one area. We have a multidisciplinary team. The 70 people is a big group with different knowledges in order to can transform different byproducts and different molecules and maximize in an integrated way, in a biorefinery way, in different molecules. So the main objective of Alchemy, as I already start mentioning, is first of all to create this software, advanced software to promote synthetic biology. We also aim to maximize the productivity of fermentation and production of new molecules together with Emerville in San Francisco that John will explain briefly. And then looking for all the biomolecules that Amyris is producing. Usually they are producing with a focus of cosmetic, a focus of food, but this molecule sometimes entails several properties that you can look and maximize the value and bring these molecules to new sectors. And this is really important because you can maximize the value of these molecules. And finally, we are transforming, extracting, valorizing all the waste streams that Amyris is producing during the fermentation from the sugarcane plants to the spent yeast and all the liquids obtained during the downstream. So just to tell you, we look our approach, we start looking the waste. We look all the molecules that they can have. So we have been analyzing more than 1,000 molecules and understanding the amount and the potential of these molecules in the waste stream. And then we apply a specific extraction and then always green technology in order to avoid contamination of the planet. And then what we try to do is looking the potential of these molecules. So we screen different biological properties for these molecules. And from there, we can define all the final ingredients that you can get and in which fields can we apply them. So at the moment, most of the focus had been through the cosmetic industry, but we have in the project we expect after 5 years to have at least 32 new products that come from these waste streams. And there is, in fact, a synergy among different industries. We can have products, we have been planned products for agrochemical, we have also products for pharma, products for food, products for cosmetics. And what we are is to get collaboration through Amyris with this industrial symbiosis for applications, and starting mainly from Amyris applications with a very strong component of cosmetic. I want to tell you about our first product in the market at the moment. So in June, we have announced the first molecule obtained from the waste streams. So in this case, our first molecule is coming from the ashes that we obtain from the sugarcane process. So when we have the sugarcane in Brazil, we extract the syrup. This syrup is moving to the fermentation. After this extraction, we obtain the bagasse. Bagasse is then transformed in energy in order to obtain energy to feed the industry. And at the end, we have ashes. At the moment, the ashes, they don't have any application, are the last element of the process. So what we tried to do was to analyze these ashes. And in fact, these ashes are really rich in silica. So what we did, developing an innovative technology, we have been purifying the silica. And at the moment, we obtained the first biogenic silica from a plant. So you already have a silica. Biogenic silica in the market coming from diatomaceous, but from plant is the first one. So we extract with 99% purity this biosilica that it is at the moment one clean ingredient for the cosmetic industry, and is already at the moment being tested with some companies that probably John will talk now. So this is, we are really proud of our first ingredient, and we expect in the coming months and years to produce much more from these waste streams. So thank you so much for your attention.
Very amazing, thank you. So now we should be getting John online. There he is. Hello, John. Very nice to have you with us. Welcome.
Good afternoon, Alexandra. It's very nice to be with you. And I'm so sorry I am not there physically. COVID has seemed to change many of our lives. But I am so glad to be invited and at least part of you virtually. So great to be with you. And I'll make a few comments and then hopefully be able to have a dialogue with you and some questions. I think what Manuela has failed to say is this work on the circular economy and really taking waste and making it better, making it valuable, making it sustainable, and delivering high impact products would not be possible without her and really her passion and commitment to making the world better. When I first met Manuela, I saw the amazing work she was doing in her lab and at the university. And I realized that the missing part was finding a market and finding the ability to commercialize so that it could actually make a difference. Because my belief is science without a market and without people can't actually make a difference. And so that's really what led to our partnership, and I am so happy that we are working together and that we have really a great start in products that are already starting to commercialize, like biosilica, which replaces the need to use lots of energy to convert sand into silica, which is a base product that's used in about 10% of the cosmetics industry. So anyway, a little bit of background. What do we do? We as a company do something very simple. We really make the rarest molecules, the rarest chemistry in the world that comes from plants, that comes from animals, that comes from petroleum, and we make it in a way that's sustainable. We make it by fermentation, the same technology that makes beer, that makes wine, that makes bread, that we've been used to for a couple of thousand years. We use that same technology to take sugarcane syrup, which is a great source of natural carbon, and we convert that sugarcane syrup into some of the world's best molecules. As a matter of fact, I would not be surprised if about one third of the people in our audience are not already using a product that has an ingredient that is made through our technology and through our process. And that really connects back to our mission. Our whole mission is to accelerate the transition to sustainable consumption. We really believe that little by little, by making ingredients better, by making them natural, by making them sustainable, we make products for consumers that are better. And consumers then will actually choose those products. And by choosing those products that are sustainably sourced, we actually could make our planet more sustainable. Or more importantly, we can leave our planet better for those that come behind us, like our children and our grandchildren. And that for me is really the purpose. It's the mission. It's why we do this. We do this because I want my kids and my grandkids to have some of the same choices and access to some of the same products and materials that I've grown up with, that I've loved. And I want them to do that without damaging our planet by actually finding a more sustainable way to make products. I want to share with you one example, one story that is really very, very impactful right now, which is really about COVID and vaccines. We make a product called squalene, which is actually part of vaccines. Some vaccines use a technology called an adjuvant that makes the vaccine more powerful, makes the vaccine more sustainable, and helps the vaccine avoid human resistance so that it has higher efficacy. That molecule, squalene, for many years has been sourced from killing sharks. And the way to think about it is it takes about 500,000 sharks to extract enough squalene for 1 billion vaccines. So what we've done is through fermentation and through chemistry, we actually take sugarcane syrup from Brazil and we make squalene that is a high quality, high purity, high performing ingredient in adjuvants for vaccines. So let me make this even simpler for you. 10 hectares of sugarcane represent enough squalene for 1 billion vaccines, which is the equivalent of killing 500,000 sharks. And I share this with you because it's the greatest example of sustainability. So let me make it even simpler. The 10 hectares that make enough squalene for 1 billion vaccines can grow the sugarcane to make that squalene every year. Same 10 hectares. So you don't have to go find 10 new hectares. You just keep growing the sugarcane and you harvest, you process, you make the squalene. When you kill 500,000 sharks, those sharks can never reproduce again. Those sharks can never contribute to the ecosystem of our oceans again. Those sharks are gone forever. That is not a sustainable way to make squalene, and that is not the way we should be making great vaccines. We should be doing it in a sustainable way that makes the world better, that delivers high purity and performance. And I share that story because that is a simple way to understand what sustainability is and how fermentation combined with biotechnology can make the world much better for everybody. We're doing exactly what I shared with you on vaccines for the beauty industry, for personal care. We have the largest supply of natural ingredients to the aroma and the flavors industry. And that really gives you a sense of how broad we are. And what we do. To end, I want to bring it all the way back to alchemy and what Manuela is doing. As good as biotechnology is and fermentation is, there's still an issue. When you do the fermentation, you have a lot of waste. That waste can be used and is used today for things like fertilizer for the sugarcane so that it's all a natural circular process. But I believe there's more, which is why we partnered with Crédito Angelica and Manuel for the Alchemy Project. And the more is around taking the ash, taking the leaves, taking the vinasse, understanding the chemistry in those products, and then replacing existing solutions to give consumers a more sustainable way to live. It's so far going very well. I'm so excited about the impact we can have. And, you know, I think if we can make sustainability sexy, then we can make sustainability mainstream. And I think by impacting the beauty industry, dealing with personal care products, being in your home every day, we have a way to make it sexy, to make it impactful, to make it economic, and through that, move the world to sustainable consumption. So, Alejandra, I hope that was helpful, and I'm happy to take questions with Manuela so that we can try to answer some of the thoughts.
That was extremely interesting. And there's one thing that I would like to know that doesn't necessarily relate to science, but that I find that has been very good, that an American company came all the way to Portugal to find a partner in research and development. How did that come to be?
It's a little more complicated than that. And I would actually say that the university came to the U.S.
Yeah.
And by accident, we discovered each other.
Yeah.
And the history goes back a bit further. I'm originally from the Pico Island in the Azores. And so being from the Azores and going back every summer, I really experienced nature in a different way. I remember walking through the island and smelling nature and hearing nature. And that experience made me realize at the core that I wanted my children and I wanted future generations to have that same experience of really smelling and hearing nature in a powerful way, which kind of, again, inspired me to find a better way to sustainable high-performance chemistry. And then the council at the Portuguese council in San Francisco had asked me to host a dinner for the university. So I hosted the university, the leadership team, including Manuela, for a dinner at my house. She sat next to me. She told me the story about how she was dealing with waste streams. And I thought, we have to find a partnership because we have to make the waste in Brazil from sugarcane more valuable and more impactful for our planet. So that's how it happened.
Yeah. Maybe I can compliment just sometimes when we are working in these sustainable areas, circular economy, we need to communicate. It's really important. Sometimes we just work in the research and you just publish. So we need to take our message to the world. So I think what we did at that moment in this visit was just to communicate, share what we are doing, exciting the companies. And this is the match between the science and how can science can be transferred. So it's really important. This is a message for all the research centers, all the universities. Take the role of what you are doing in sustainability, circular economy. And I believe that your exciting will excite new companies to implement your solution. So I think it's crucial that.
I totally agree. I mean, the intersection between academia and business has to happen.
Yes, otherwise.
And do you work with other waste streams, Manuela?
Yeah. Well, in fact, when we start working since 1993, we have been working with agri-food, so agriculture and food industries. So we have been working with different from the plant processing to meat processing, beer processing, and all this experience let us understand how these waste streams can be valuable and how can we explore this value, especially in nowadays. Amounts, quantities of streams are really important. So we need to not just work in research, we need to understand sustainability, economic sustainability of the processes, and especially we need also to maximize the value because we need to do it in a biorefinery concept. You cannot just to take 0.1 milligram of a molecule. You need to take 0.1 and then think about how can we valorize the other components and obtain zero waste, because sometimes we try to take something, but then the waste is still worse. So we need to be maintain and assure that we are using green technologies and especially zero waste at the end. Otherwise, sometimes it's not so interesting and we are not saving the planet in same way. So it's important to think about these concepts all the time when you do this research.
So I imagine you also have in your team people considering energy efficiency and the economy of it all. You have to make your product be economically feasible.
Yes. Well, at this moment, we interact with the business school too that supports us on that topic, but especially the company. So this is a role that we usually expect from the company that help us to understand how can we make this product profits and how can we make the value in the market. So we interact with some teams. We have a PD team, a product development team, that supports all the other researchers analyzing the economics of the ingredient, the process, and only these economics are equivalent to the ingredient in the market, then we can proceed. But the most important thing is always performance. So we need always to demonstrate that ingredient that is coming from the waste stream, it's high performance or similar or specially, and we prefer, we fight for that better than what we have from synthetic sources. So, and finally, it's the safety. It's really important. We need to demonstrate always to the consumer that even it's coming from the waste, it's safe. And so it's crucial, and these three components are usually the way how we can demonstrate and make the consumer safe and happy because they are using the equivalent or better products in a sustainable way.
Yes, I agree. Safety and trust, because
trust, of course. Yeah.
You're dealing with cosmetics that people use on your body and medicines.
Yeah, but if you can prove the safety, the performance, and that's the is an equivalent price, it's they will be it's trust for them. Yeah, they trust us, I believe.
So do you see, John, just to wrap up our, we are coming to the end of our time, do people favor products that have this component, this strategy?
We are, one of our businesses is we have a brand in the U.S. It's actually now in London and Australia and going into China, a brand called Bounce, which is now the fastest growing skincare brand in North America. And to me, that's a perfect example of what the consumer will do. It's important to remember, a beauty consumer is not going to wake up in the morning and say, oh, I want to go buy sustainability. They wake up in the morning and say, I want better skin. I want healthier skin. I want to look younger. Whatever their objective is, that's what they ask for, not more sustainable. Yep. If it is more sustainable and it's the best product to make their skin healthier, then what they do is choose your brand and stay with your brand. So I believe sustainability is a way to keep the consumer with your brand because it's a better way for them. It's a way for them to contribute to make our planet better. And to complete the conversation.
Yeah, our time has come to an end. I'm sorry. But anyway, this was very informative. I mean, I bet a lot of people had no idea that what was happening to all this waste stream and how much you get out of it and throughout the world. I mean, it doesn't remain here. It goes all over the world. Yeah. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.